guys, this is your trainer Shazib Hasan, and thank you for watching this video. And today I am going to introduce Aveva Pro 2 process engineering small or technical tutorial, which is linked with the phase envelope. A simple problem which I am going to define here first, then I will use this tool to simulate this phase envelope problem and then describe its solution. So let's start with this gas processing problem. As you see that for simplicity, I just explain here the problem or issues that is faced by many engineers in the field. It's written here that a high pressure natural gas stream is being transported through pipeline. Okay, it's natural gas. You need to establish whether liquid will drop out during a cold winter, like when temperature goes down in negative scale, and if so, what you must do to prevent it. So the first step is to determine the conditions under which the liquid will appear. The easiest way to do this is to introduce a phase envelope for the gas mixture and examine the boundary of the two phases. As most of the viewers have been using SPNSS and doing this, but if we talk about the Aveva Pro 2 process engineering, it is the first time I think someone is trying to introduce it with the help of this tutorial. So I have a plan to do some more exercises on this software whenever I get time from my busy schedule. So I hope you will like this video. So here's the gas stream composition given. So what we need to do in the first few steps, that we will introduce or add these components in the component list, and then we will select the property package which is normally when we talk about oil and gas, and from refinery perspective, Pang Robinson PR is mostly selected. SRK can also work here. So this example uses SRK, so we will try to use it the same to get the same results in terms of composition and the phase changes, temperature. So let's start. I'm going to start the Aveva Pro 2 process engineering software again from the desktop, and this is a small window opens which shows that if your entry data is blue in color, then it means that the entry is satisfied. So it's just for the information, and for those guys who have been using this Aveva Pro 2 processing, there is no need to read it again and again. So let's start with the new simulation. Okay, it's not very difficult software, it's easy as SPNSS and Unisim design. So let's start with the component list. Select from the list. Okay, let's see. We need to add nitrogen, methane, ethane, propane, and butane, and pentane, and hexane. So nitrogen is here. Like if I use this SimSci name, then I will write just C1, methane, add C2, methane, add C3, propane, add put in. Here it is, an exam. So our list is completed, and now we will move towards thermodynamic packet selection. So let's verify it again. That is methane. Okay, so all the components are here. Click OK. Now we have to choose the thermodynamic package, which in our case, Pang Robinson. Pang Robinson I added, so we can also modify it from here, that if I want to select the vapor liquid equilibrium in SRK mode, then I will click it out, and enthalpy liquid vapor okay, so vapor liquid enthalpy, vapor enthalpy is SRK. Okay, let's read it out. And the phase angle will solve using either SRK or Pang Robinson. So, this is number 27. Example, the phase angle may be generated for any pressured steam, whether it is defined feed steam or a product steam from a heat operation. Only the steam composition. Okay, the phase angle is the function of only the steam composition. All you need to do is generate the complete envelope to select the stream. No initial estimates are required. The critical point, this click on Danton, and critical condensed pressure will be calculated. Okay, so we have completed this component selection dialog box, and we have modified the thermodynamic data for equilibrium and enthalpy calculations as we have already done this, and let's click okay. Now we will select the stream from here and just double click it, do it. So we will take 100 pound mole per hour. Okay, so if I want to change this pound mole per hour, then what I need to do is to just click from the unit of measurements, like if it is currently measuring in pound mole per hour, then I can change it to the pound per hour or tons per day or anything I want to. In terms of system of units, I can do that also. Okay, now composition. Composition is given in the starting table. Okay, here it is. So that is 1.4. So it's 0.014. C1 is 0.943. So composition is mole. So I'm dividing it with 100. Ethane is 2.6, so it's 0.026. C3, propane is 0.68, so 0.068. Butane is 0.4, so 0.00044. So it's 0.068, so it's this one. 0.37 and 0.0021. So its total is now 1. So it means that our composition is now correct, and we have correctly put the composition from this given table to here. So let's click OK. OK. So now the stream is here. So the default temperature and pressures, if you want to add it, then it's okay. Because for the calculation of phase envelope, there is not such requirement of entering the pressure and temperatures. So I'm doing of 1 bar pressure and 98 degree Fahrenheit temperature. So click yes. Okay, so what's the next step? Okay, we have already done that. Yes. Okay, so to generate the phase diagram on the stream, double click the phase diagram icon on the flow sheet. The phase envelope dialog box appears. Okay, so we have to find out from here. Heating curve is here, and as if we click here, then there is a phase envelope. So double click this one. Okay, so select the stream from the top and use phase diagram required. In this case, stream 1. You can generate curves for stream 1 with constant liquid mole fraction. The constant liquid fraction curves are superimposed on the envelope. Okay. Okay. What I'm doing here is I just first in the first case I'm leaving this liquid mole fraction blank. It means that the phase envelope which is calculated by the Pro 2 has no superimposed condensation like I do in the second case. Like 5% of liquid will be condensed, and in the third case 1% of liquid will be condensed. So this three cases are now set up. Okay. So this shows that simulation is converged now. This blue color is showing that the solution is fine. Okay, now we have to analyze the streams. Okay, I will go into the tools and then click face envelope. Select the S1 stream, or it's the name of our stream S1. And now I will write here 0.05% mole fraction, 0.01% show table. Okay, here's the table, and I want to see the plots. So here's the plot of the face envelope. Okay, so what is written in our PDF file? The following plot was generated from the solution. So as in the example, the plot is given is similar to our trend result, that it's showing that at 28 degree Fahrenheit, if our temperature goes below that, then we have condensation and there will be a liquid phase in the stream. So all we need to do is to improve our stream temperature above the 28 degree Fahrenheit, not to condense our gases in the high pressure natural gas stream. Okay, so the conclusion is also written here. If temperature below 28 degrees Fahrenheit possible, condensation would occur in parts of the pipeline which are exposed to the atmosphere, as we have already discussed in our actual case. And you will need to study the specific pipeline further to establish whether heaters are required or if insulation will be sufficient. Alternatively, you might consider removing more of the heavier components in the gas stream treatment. Okay, so if you remove the C6 component from the stream or C5, then this temperature will be improved and you have a relatively no condensation in the stream. So the output, the plot shows the envelope with the lines of constant liquid fraction at 1%, 5%, 2%. As I discussed earlier, that I developed three cases. One is without any forced condensation, the second one is the 1% forced condensation, and 5% for superimposed condensation. So if you could accept up to 1% liquid in your line, if it is bearable, there would be no problems unless the temperature falls below -19 degree Fahrenheit. So with the 1% condensation, if it is allowable, then the temperature from 28 degree F to reduces to this -19 degree F, because with 1% condensation you have narrow boundaries available to bear the excessive condensation in the if it is increased from 1%. So the next steps, this tutorial is helping us to understand that how we can generate the reports and notify our results with the others. So this report snapshot is also attached in this sheet. As you see that the critical point is 28 dew point, 28 F, and this case is without any forced condensation. Critical condensation temperature is here, this -28.4. Okay, let's see how can we generate the plots. No, let's see the outputs. Generate text report. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so the report is generated. Global deviation 0%. Yeah, here in the report it was 28 around, and in my report it's 29.23. This table is showing the values without any superimposed condensation in the line, and if we move further we will see that there is also a trend or a graph available for this phase envelope, as also mentioned in the report. With the 5% superimposed condensation, our critical temperature will be reduced to -81. So above that there you can say that if the 5% condensation is allowed, then below that temperature you will have more than 5% condensation. So there is also trend available, and the last one is the 1%. With the 1% you can go maximum at -22. In the report case there was minus 19 mentioned here, so there is not much difference. So this is the detailed report of the phase envelope, which is very good to understand and very understandable and very technical to share with your technical team. So this is a small simulation on the Aveva Pro process simulation software, and I have the other tutorials available in this sheet, and whenever I get time I will my next tutorial would be this one, create another simulation using Pro 2 Aveva. So thank you very much for watching this small tutorial, and subscribe my channel, and connect with me on LinkedIn. My name is Ajay Basan and I'm chartered chemical engineer. So thank you very much.